गुड मॉर्निंग एवरी वन, माई सेल्फ डॉक्टर विश्वराज लाल, फैकल्टी ऑफ बायोटेक्नोलॉजी, जमशेदपुर वुमेंस कॉलेज, जमशेदपुर। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट वैक्सीन्स एंड इट टाइप्स। फर्स्ट वी डिस्कस व्हाट इज वैक्सीन, डिस्कवरी, हाउ डू वैक्सीन वर्क, एंड लास्टली टाइप्स। सो स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम वैक्सीन, द वर्ड वैक्सीन ओरिजिनेट फ्रॉम द लैटिन वेरियोली वैक्सीन Capox, which Edward Jenner demonstrated in 1798 could prevent smallpox. A vaccine is a biological preparation that improves immunity to a particular disease. A vaccine topically contains an agent that resembles a disease causing microorganisms and is often made from weakened or killed forms of the microbes. Vaccines are administered in liquid form, either by injections, by oral, or by intranasal routes. So, in very basic terms, we can say that vaccine is going to induce our immunity. It improves our immunity because these are nothing but microorganisms. So, those microorganisms that can cause infection in us, result in disease in us. So what we are doing, we injecting little dose of those microorganisms in activated forms into our bloodstream, so that our body immune systems going to be familiar with them and influenced by them to produce proper antibody against them. Once our body produces antibody, which is very specific fighting agents against those antigens or those pathogens, in future, same kind of bacteria or microorganisms infect us, then in our body, those antibodies are already been prepared. So our body ready to fight against them. So this is the overall about vaccines. Next, we are coming to discovery. 1719, Edward Jenner uses cowpox virus to successfully vaccinate against smallpox. Louis Pasteur's 1880s developed first effective rabies vaccines. In 1900s, typhoid and cholera vaccines are first developed. 1910s, tetanus vaccines becomes widely available. In 1920s, tuberculosis vaccines becomes available. 1930s, diphtheria and yellow fever vaccines come on stream. 1950s, poliomyelitis vaccine developed. 1960s, measles, mumps and rubella vaccine develops. 1980s, initial subunit vaccines, example hepatitis B, produced by recombinant DNA technology. In 1990s, ongoing development of subunit vaccines and vaccines against autoimmune disease and cancers. Next is come, how do vaccines work? The first steps in appreciating the importance of vaccination is to understand how your body immune system reacts when it first encounters germs and bugs that makes you sick. In your body, you have white blood cells which constantly patrol your body for things which should not be there, example germs. When they detect these bugs, your white blood cells start to produce an immune response. Basically, this immune response involves producing many white blood cells that will recognize and kill these bugs. The problem is your white blood cells are like first year university students. They have absolutely no idea what to do and how to properly control foreign germs when they first enter your body. So while your white blood cells try to figure out what to do with these germs, the bugs grow and release toxins, which make you develop all those Next is symptoms associated with vaccine, preventable disease, example, measles. After a little, your white blood cells rise up and manage to associate all the bugs and you start feeling better again. The immune systems also develop a memory of the event so that should you come into contact with the germs again, it can quickly and efficiently deal with the infections and avoid you developing major symptoms of the disease. Next, coming to our types. First is live attenuated vaccines. Second is killed vaccines. Third is subunit vaccines. Fourth is toxoid vaccines. And fifth is DNA vaccines. And lastly is recombinant vector vaccines. First, live attenuated vaccines. What is the meaning of attenuated? Attenuated का मतलब होता है एक ऐसा वैक्सीन, एक ऐसा पैथोजन जिसको कि मैंने वीक बना दिया है, जिंदा है बट उसका जो पैथोजेनिसिटी है उसको मैंने कम कर दिया है, ताकि व्हेन वी गोइंग टू इंट्रोड्यूस दिस इन योर बॉडी इज इन इफेक्टिव, दे डू नॉट कॉज एनी डिजीज. सो विच वैक्सीन्स आर लाइव एटेनेटेड, एग्जाम्पल BCG, ओरल पोलियो वैक्सीन्स, चिकन पॉक्स, येलो फीवर, रूबेला, मिजल्स, मम्स एक्सेट्रा. सो वी कैन से दैट दिस वैक्सीन्स आर कंपोज ऑफ लाइव एट्यूनेटेड माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिजम्स दैट कॉज अ लिमिटेड इन्फेक्शंस इन देयर होस्ट सफिशियंट टू इंड्यूस एन इम्यून रेस्पॉन्स बट इन सफिशियंट टू कॉज डिजीज. टू मेक एन एट्यूनेटेड वैक्सीन द पैथोजन इज ग्रोन इन फॉरेन होस्ट such as animals, embryonated eggs or tissue culture under conditions that make it less virulent. A major advantage of live vaccine is that because they cause infections, the vaccine very closely reproduce the natural stimulus to the immune response. Next, killed vaccines, killed inactivated vaccine, when it is unsafe to use live microorganisms to prepare vaccines, they are killed or inactivated. These are preparations of the normal infectious pathogenic microorganisms that have been rendered non-pathogenic, usually by treatment with using heat, formaldehyde or gamma irradiation, so that they cannot replicate at all. Such killed vaccines vary greatly in their efficiency. Example, cholera, flu, hepatitis A, rabies, etc. Next is subunit vaccines. Instead of the entire microbe, subunit vaccine include only the antigens that best stimulate the immune systems. In some case, this vaccine use epitope, the very specific parts of antigens that antibodies or T cells recognize and bind to. Because subunit vaccines contain only the essential antigens and not all the other molecules that make up the microbes, example hepatitis B, pertussis, pneumonia, etc. Next, toxoid vaccines for bacteria that secretes toxins or harmful chemicals. A toxoid vaccine might be the answer. This vaccine are used when a bacteria toxin is the main cause of illness. Scientists have found that they can inactivate toxins by treating them with formalin. Such detoxified toxins called toxoid are safe for use in vaccine. Example, diphtheria, tetanus. तो टॉक्सॉइड वैक्सीन्स में सबसे पहले हम लोग क्या करते हैं, जो टॉक्सिन होते हैं पैथोजन के, उसको सबसे पहले डिटॉक्सिफाई बनाते हैं. सो हियर वी आर यूजिंग डिटॉक्सिकेटेड टॉक्सिन्स. सो दिस ऑल अबाउट रिगार्डिंग वैक्सीन्स एंड इट्स टाइप्स. नेक्स्ट part 2 we will discuss about DNA vaccines and recombinant factor vaccines. Thank you.